You're watching BATV, bringing Brookline home.
Is a neighborhood of Brookline, Massachusetts, centered around the intersection of Beacon Street and Harvard Street. The neighborhood takes its name from the Coolidge Brothers General Store that opened in 1857 at that intersection on the location of today's SS Pierce Building. The SS Pierce Building, constructed in 1898 and originally a grocery store, is a historically significant Tudor-style building. It has accommodated a number of businesses over the years and is recognizable by its large clock tower, visible from nearly all points in Coolidge Corner. Developed as a transit-oriented streetcar suburb, Coolidge Corner retains a pedestrian-friendly, walkable feel. Many popular coffee shops, pharmacies, independent boutiques, and ethnic restaurants are located there, as well as a few retail chain stores.
There's a tremendous amount of potential in Coolidge Corner, and I think, you know, when we opened our doors in 97, it was a time period, there was an economic slowdown and then a startup, and I think businesses were restarting, and there was a lot of corporate money infused into real estate in and around this commercial area. And I think, you know, over the years I've seen this balance of more the independents like ourselves, like the Coolidge Corner Theater, like the Booksmith, like the J.P. Licks, the Rami's, the Bottegas. I mean, there's wonderful businesses. There's merchants here that do business across the street, Fire Opal, that are just wonderful and bring, you know, a tremendous diversity to this neighborhood. And those, I just see those businesses continuing to flourish with the support of the local community as well as reaching out to Greater Boston. I think there's a wonderful loyalty to the clientele around here. And I would say about 80% of our guest base is repeat business. And I know we reach out to a broad base from Cambridge and Newton and JP and Boston proper and all. But Brookline itself is a neighborhood. It's a pretty special place to do business.
First of all, we had competition down the street in a Barnes & Noble for a dozen years, and they're no longer here. And I think a lot of it is like how much the community is behind a store like this and how much the community itself has kind of defined what the store has become over the years. As of next year, we'll have been open for 50 years, going on our 50-year anniversary. We've had the same owner, Marshall Smith, the namesake of the store, and he's very much still involved. The store started out under the name Paperback Booksmith, and is one of the first paperback bookstores in the country. At the time, it was kind of a new thing.
Corner Theater actually started as a church in 1911. It was built as a church. And then in 1933, it became the first movie theater in Brookline. And there was a lot of controversy. In fact, we have all the clippings from the newspapers of that time. People really thought that this was going to lead the community into rack and ruin, you know, and a very bad thing. But the majority prevailed, and it did become a theater, and it became this beautiful Art Deco movie palace. This theater is very much a mission-driven art house theater. You know, it's really one of the top art house theaters in the country. And I think one of the things that makes it so special is its relationship, its ongoing conversation with its community. And by community, I mean, of course, the local community, which is Brookline, but the larger film-loving cultural community. And I think it speaks very well with both of these, the microcosm and the macrocosm of community.
We have like a mixed bag of events, book events, wherein you can meet your favorite, novelists. Sometimes we had Run DMC here. We have a pretty mixed bag of folks who write books as it is, and as well as we do, Brookline High School does their annual poetry event here, which is one of the most amazing things that happens here every year.
I've been in high school so long, you'd think by now I'd graduated, but then I'd miss the changes students say that they created. Yo, I've been busting rhymes since before your parents dated. I had time to write these lines and get some senior papers graded.
We did I think it was our 10-year anniversary, and it encompasses a lot of the flavor of the neighborhood. We had mentors, artist mentors. It's this inner city group that works with inner city kids, and so they came out here with a half a dozen mentors and took these kids from the community and from inner city schools and made this collage for us, and then we painted it on the side of the building.
We are in our eighth year now of our Coolidge Award program. We decided that the Coolidge Award every year would be given to a film artist whose work is consistently original and challenging. So we decided the first year we would give our Coolidge Award to foreign language director. And we made it even harder for ourselves because we invited the great Chinese film director Zhang Yimou, who lives in Beijing and who doesn't speak English. And so, I tracked him down, I found him, I got someone who knew him, and she invited him on our behalf, and he came. That was huge, because I think the year before that, he had been invited to the New York Film Festival, and the Chinese government would not let him come. But we got him to Brookline, to Coolidge Corner. And he came, and we, I think, didn't even realize how important he is to the Chinese community everywhere. So at that time, our big theater held 600 seats, and it was filled to overflowing. And I thought, wow, we're like the little theater that could. It wasn't that long ago, when our board members were taping up the seats so people wouldn't fall through them. And now we're presenting these world-class film artists and sharing them with the community.
Coolidge Corner is the vibrant commercial hub of Brookline. Located right on the Green Line, Coolidge Corner is just a few minutes away from downtown Boston. Stop by Coolidge Corner today for a day of shopping, eating, and entertainment in one of the coolest urban neighborhoods in the country.